Hey guys, it's Dave from Wildsby Roots. This is a short little video. I got a package today that I'm pretty excited about, and we'll actually create some videos to come when I show you how to use the product. So anyway, I did already open it. I couldn't wait. So I already opened it. I'll show you what came inside. Anyway, this is from Beaver Bushcraft. So, came in a pretty protected bag, mailing bag. So it's got the wait for it. There you go. It's got the bubble wrapping in to protect it, and everything came inside a large bag. But all the pieces inside are also bubble wrapped, so they're protected as well. Even inside of that, so everything was well packaged, basically is what I'm trying to say. There's a card, Helen and Mark, from Beaver Bushcraft. So what I ordered was... I ordered the Fire Buddy, and I also, that's from Beaver Bushcraft, apparently. I also ordered a hand-forged, traditional pendulum. I'll show you that, but, it's a fire steel. So, and that's from, Bethel Forge, apparently. I'm just kind of reading the notes on the, invoice anyway. So that's from Bethel Forge, but I'll show you. But Helen was gracious enough, super awesome people. She was nice enough to send me some samples of some of their tinder and such. So like here is an example. She sent me a little sample here of some Amadou, and she also sent me some, pull it out of the bag. Here's a little example of some char cloth. Came in a little baggie. So everything was separated into nice little baggies. So there's some Amadou, some char cloth, and then some Amadou down. You can see that. Nice little baggie. It's just super awesome. I mean, you know. So I can't wait to try the actual product out that I ordered, two of them, both of them, and try it with some of these tinders. But here's some jupe twine she sent. Again, awesome, because here's some these are toothpicks with sulfur. So these are sulfur matches. Basically you would use your fire steel and some char cloth or something along those lines, one of the tinders. You would get an ember going, and then you would take one of these sulfur matches, and you would light it, you would ignite it with the ember, and then you would have yourself a flame. And I will do a video demonstrating all of that. But you have yourself a flame, and then you can use that to light whatever, light a candle or something along those lines. So I was saying to Trish earlier, it's just what a difference in, the way we live and the way they lived back then. That would have been the norm, right? So you get your fire steel out, you get your flint out, your char cloth, whatever else, and you get that ember going, and then you would take your sulfur match and light it off of that just to light a candle, and that would have been the norm. They wouldn't have thought anything of it, right? So, but today we would just be like, oh my God, that's so much work, such a hassle to have to do that. And it's just such a, a difference in mentality, and that's how these, I really do, I think that's how these people were able to build and make things and go the distance in everything that they did in life, because they were accustomed to it. They were built for it from the time they were young. They just endured so much. They were just, they had a different perspective in life than we do. Everything is so easy for us. It comes so easy. You know, I want to light that candle, I'll just pull my Bic, or I'll just light a match, you know. Whereas, you know, this took like how many different steps just to light a candle, you know, or your, you know, lantern or something along those lines, right? So, just that mindset, just, I don't know, it's fascinating to me anyway. Now I'm rambling about something completely different. But anyway, so I just want to say thank you, Helen. You know, sending me all the examples was so awesome, and I'll be able to do some wicked videos with it all. So that's just awesome. Awesome. I really appreciate it. So now to the main event. This was, see, everything is bubble wrapped. Everything's protected, which is super awesome. Let's open this up. I think this is the flint. I think that's what this is. Watch me open it. Oh yeah. Look at that. Oh. How big that is. It's a huge piece of flint. That is awesome. Whoa. Oh man, that's so cool. Tell me you don't get excited about this. Check that out. Wow, it's awesome. So there's the flint. We'll put that that aside, and then where's my okay, so here's the fire buddy. Very small. I actually got some technical notes for it, so I'll kind of spew them off real quick. But then when I actually go and do a video on it, and I'm using it, I'll repeat myself. Look at that. You can see that. This is really nice. You see the edges? Can you see the edges on that? That's for using this. The edges here are for using it with a ferro rod. So you can actually use this with a ferro rod. Both sides are 90 degrees. See if I can remember the stats without looking at the thing. It's a no, I'm gonna look at it because I don't want to do the wrong stats. I believe it was 70. Yep, 70 mils. Millimeters by 30 millimeters, and then the whole thing weighs 88 grams. It's what the Fire Buddy is. It's a bearing block for when you're using a bow drill. So as I was saying, this is a bearing block, right? So you would hold it in your hand while you're doing your bow drill, and you would. You can see this middle notch here, right? So you would go in there, and they recommend that you lubricate this with petroleum jelly, oil, or say you're out in the bush and you don't have those things. You could use a leaf or some grass, but they recommend that you lubricate it. But and you can also use it. You see they got the holes here on either. Oh, sorry. You can see they have the holes here on either side. And what that's meant for, when I do an actual video on it, I'll show you. But anyway, you take a piece of cordage, and you run it up into one hole, over the top, down through the other, and you make thumb loops. And then you would take your spindle basically and put it up into the center hole here, and you would put your thumbs through the loops that you created through the cordage, and then you could use it as a hand drill. But instead of your hand sliding down, your hand would stay basically stationary while you rubbed it back and forth and caused the friction, right? But I'll show you. And they have a video on their site as well, so you can go check it all out on their site. And I'll put a link at the bottom of this video to the site, and you can go and check it out yourself. But yeah, it's meant to be used with flint and steel. You can use it like a flint and steel. You can use it with a ferro rod on the 90-degree edges. You can use it as a bearing block for a bow drill, or you can use it as a hand drill as well. So their site is quite descriptive in regards to its uses and so on and so forth. But it's pretty cool. So go check it out. The other thing that I got was a pendant. What did I do with it? Pendant. Here it is. So, like I said earlier, the pendant was hand forged by Bethel Forge. Again, I'm reading the notes, but I thought this was cool. It just looked rugged, and again, this is for using with a flint, so a fire steel. So there it is there. You can see it. So you could put a piece of a paracord through the top here, and you can just kind of wear it around your neck if you wanted to. Take it out. But I'm sure that you could use this with a ferro rod as well, because it's got some decent edges on it. I'm more than sure that you could use this with a ferro rod. So I wish I had a ferro rod. I don't have one right now, because when I was out with my son, I put my ferro rod in a geocatch, and that was my last one, so I haven't ordered one yet. Haven't ordered a replacement yet, so it's been a while since I should have done that already. But anyway, so somebody has my ferro rod, because last time I was in the bush, I checked the geocatch, and it was gone. So somebody's got it. But anyway, so awesome packaging, awesome product. I can't wait to get out into the bush to use these. Go check out their website, and like I said, I'll put a link to Beaver Bushcraft, the online website. They're also on Facebook as well. I believe they are on Instagram, and they are on YouTube as well. So I'll put a link to all of it in the description box in this video. Okay, so just want to say thank you again, Helen, for sending me all these samples. It is awesome. I can't wait to do some videos of this stuff and try using it. So I really think that these are cool. I really do. I love the historical value behind it. It's just awesome. It blows my mind. So thank you, Beaver Bushcraft. Really, really appreciate it, and awesome products, awesome job, and this design, like this whole thing is just the Fire Buddy. Such a small little package here. I mean, you can see it's in my hand. It's such a small little package, and yet it is designed to do so much and to be used with everything, you know, as far as fire making goes. It's an ingenious design, really. It is. There's a lot of thought behind this. So go check out their website and order yourself one. There, I said it. Get one. Period. Again, so I'll put all the links down below. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs up, comment, so on and so forth. Helen and Mark, Beaver Bushcraft. Awesome. Awesome people, too. They really are. Salt of the earth. Thanks for watching.